Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting off this video, we have some launch information. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Starlink 19 is now expected tomorrow, Monday 15th. It should lift off at 4:20 a.m. UTC or 11:20 p.m. EDT. Not only is that launch expected this coming week, but also we should see the delayed Starlink 17 launch. That liftoff is expected on Wednesday 17th at 5:55 a.m. UTC or 12:55 a.m. EDT. NASA have announced some of the members that will fly aboard the Crew 4 mission scheduled to launch in 2022. It says NASA astronauts Shel Lindgren and Bob Hines will serve as spacecraft commander and pilot respectively for the Crew 4 mission. There's another article about other companies disputing the Starlink constellation. It says more broadband industry groups are lining up against SpaceX's bid to get nearly $900 million in federal communications funding. Two groups representing fiber and rural internet providers yesterday submitted a report to the FCC claiming that Starlink will hit a capacity shortfall in 2028 when the satellite service may be required to hit a major FCC deployment deadline. Looking at stuff in Boca Chica, work with the orbital launch site is really coming together at speed now. Some interesting new structural work is going on in this area too. Here's a tweet from RGV Aerial Photography with a shot of the landing pad work currently going on. He said the landing pad is getting much needed upgrades, also Starship SN8 crater concrete work is being redone. Some very interesting new components were spotted arriving and being put together in the yard. Somebody added telemetry and other data to the SN9 video to demonstrate how a Falcon 9 style livestream could have looked. Everyday Astronaut tweeted about it and Musk responded with, "Good analysis. We are working on lowering minimum throttle of Raptor so that there is engine redundancy throughout the landing burn. There's a new nose cone barrel section with lead-ins spotted, possibly for SN15. A tad bit of a look at SN9 cruiser continuing to cut up pieces of the remains. SN10 was seen doing some flap testing recently as well as other work to prepare it for its static firing and flight. In terms of the upcoming testing, the remaining road closures last week were cancelled, as were the TFRs. There is still no new road closures or temporary flight restrictions." Marcus House posted a video about SN10 and its upcoming engine and flight testing with a poll on the outcome of the flight. Musk responded with some information saying success on landing probability is approximately 60% this time. SN11 was stacked recently to get it ready for its own testing campaign. SN16's aft section was hooked up to the flipping mechanism to be rotated. The SN16 leg skirt section was moved near to the aft section. As expected, these two were also hooked up to one another. Finally, to finish the video, we once again have the latest Starship and Super Heavy build status diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for going out all day every day to film this amazing Starship stuff for us fans. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.